Alright guys, here we go, round three. I'm gonna do a quick breakdown, but if you don't want me to, if you just want to skip right to the battles, that's fine. But I'm gonna go through the teams really quick here. These new teams have 2 capital ships, 4 cruisers, 8 destroyers, and 40 interceptors. On this team, the main capital ship has 7 large batteries that are very deadly and accurate at medium range. The cruiser class has 1 rail gun, which is very powerful, long range, and defense batteries. So at long range it shoots the rail gun, close range it uses these defense batteries. The destroyer class ship has 4 light cannons, which are fire very quick, but are mainly only used at close range, but it can get close with this large thruster here. It can go very quickly and straight towards its target. The interceptors here are very agile. They have 2 small plasma cannons to harass the enemy. Team 2, the capital ship, has about 8 main batteries, which are medium range, they do very high damage. Not the most accurate, but their damage is it's very well utilized. It has about 20 small missile rocket launchers. Actually, they're missiles. They're guided missiles, not rockets. Shielding and high speed, a very large thruster for high speed to move in. It also has thrusters to keep its distance and agility. So it's very agile, very powerful ship. The cruiser class has about 10 rocket launchers. They're unguided rockets, shoots very fast in one direction, and 2 long-range railguns. This ship is basically used, it's also shielded. It's basically a backline ship, so it sits back and shoots its rockets and railgun at long range, but it will go in if the computer decides that the enemy is very, you know, weak. It can go right in very quickly. And the interceptor class ship, or the destroyer class ship here, the interceptor, it has 6 missiles, 2 defense batteries, and about 10 miniguns, I think. It's not turreted, so it has to face its target, but it's very agile with these wings and thrusters on the wings. It can really aim itself very well. And it actually has thrusters on its flank so it can strafe as well. And the interceptor, the smaller ship here, is a very agile ship that shoots torpedoes, which is very good against large ships because torpedoes are slow moving, unguided, but very destructive. So let's see, team 3, the Illuminators. These are all basically the same. They're this class, these ships only have about a very few weapons to choose from. They have these death rays, which are put on the front of the 3 largest ships, the capital, cruiser, destroyer. And the main capital ship has shielding on the back. And the other weapon, actually there's 2 other weapons, but the other main weapon is point defenses. You can't really see them here because the turrets are yellow, but they're close range point defense, which can be shot at missiles, small ships, or even in an engagement. Since they're so heavily armored and large, they actually can trade very well at close range. And the third and the only other weapon typically utilized are these, they're basically like grenades, they're explosive shards that are shot out defensively. And it's basically kind of a assisting weapon to kind of spray these explosive shards around the battlefield to take out missiles or small ships, or just harass anything flying by them, because their main weapons are right on the nose, right on the tip, and they have to turn, so something passes by them, they'll shoot the explosive shards at them. Team 4, Crystal. The capital ship has some antimatter rockets, some defense turrets, but mainly 6 large, very destructive, close-range turrets. This thing will tear through just about anything at close range, as long as it gets there. The cruiser class is about the same. It has This one has 10 medium turrets, which are pretty destructive, especially at close range. The destroyer class ship has 4 light turrets, 1 antimatter missile. It's like a basic model. And the interceptor here is, on this one, it has 2 antimatter missiles and only a few, 2 thrusters. It's very slow, easily destroyed, but it can take out larger ships very well, because having 40 of these shooting rockets covers the battlefield fairly well, defensively. Team 5, the warrior class here, they have, the capital ship has heavy armor. It has about 6 long range, high damage but slow firing turrets, and a few flak turrets. Miss one large missile and 2 shield batteries. It's armored in the center here, so even getting through on the sides, you'll hit armor eventually. It's pretty durable. This ship also is fairly durable. It has armor covering the center, and it has a lot of defense turrets. It's a little slow, and it can't really get out of trouble very easily, but having so many defense turrets on the front here helps. And its main weapon is about 8 large missile launchers. And the destroyer class ship here is armored on the front, back. The sides are not armored as much, but it has 6 flak cannons, which are used defensively and offensively. 1 shield in the center to kind of protect, just in case someone shoots through on the weak sides, the shield might help out while it can turn to face them. And the warrior class ship here, for its size, it has a little bit of armor on the front, and it has the small, I think these are plasma batteries, and defense turrets. It can hold up pretty well. It's not agile at all, but for its class, it can hold up to some larger ships if their weaponry can't get through its armor and hull very well. And the last team, this team uses long-range, slow-firing, highly accurate weapons. The capital ship here has a lot of I think it's about 12 long-range batteries. It's shielded and armored, so this is a very durable ship, and if it happens to be the last ship, it can take out pretty much anything on its own. The cruiser-class ship is a missile launcher. It is armored, it has a few defense turrets, but it's mainly used to sit back and use its missiles. The destroyer-class ship here has some medium long-range batteries, which for its class, it's pretty good. It's the armor is a little bit weak on the outsides, but the center armor is very strong, so it usually gets, you know, half of it gets taken out, but it still keeps fighting fairly well. And the medium ship here, these are highly agile missile launchers, so they're basically just utilized to stay on the battlefield as long as possible and just keep shooting missiles, guided missiles out. Best against larger, slow-moving targets, but if a missile catches even a small ship, it takes it out pretty well. Alright, so without any further ado, we're going to go through the battle here. And, leave a comment, let me know what you think, what format you like me to do, and here we go.
Thank you.
All right, well, there you have it. The top team would be, well, it's a tie between the Destroyers, which is the white over there, and the Interceptors. They both had 4 wins, so they both only lost once. And I try to balance these as best as I can, but every time you make one team better or one team worse, it kind of, you know, changes around a bit. But, you know, I try to make it as balanced as possible. But let me know which battle or which team you think is the best. Which battle is the best, which team is the best, and which battle was the worst, and which team was the worst. And I'll probably put a compilation of, at some point, just the most interesting battles. And, you know, the most interesting, it might do some kind of, you know, which skirmishes between two ships kind of turned out cool. You know, it's a complete simulation. You know, all I do is make the ships and the computer runs the rest. So, you know, if you liked it, let me know. If you didn't like it, let me know. And, you know, see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Have a good one. See you later.